You guys have been great with us. You have been great with us so warm, so happy, so kindly to us. So this is really, really a blessing. And we need to say about talk about this back in Mexico, because this is something huge, really, that really unites both countries, both people. So. Well, any of this could be possible without Johnny, and I am so happy to be here because of you. You are the cornerstone of this Convergentes exhibition. So thank you so much. Well, and also the university. I'm sorry, thank you. Wow.
Yeah. Here is Dr. Vargas, so we're very thankful because he's here with his wife. Thanks to the university, because we've been walking around River Campus, feeling us like it's our house already, working with Hannah. Working with Josh, and it's been awesome. So thank you very much, Dr. Wallace.
It's my time to say thanks to Catapult Creative House, because they opened the doors like a and we deserve it. Okay, thank you a lot. It's very grateful for us to be here in order to share some of our experiences doing the printing. Yeah, that's our theme now.
Yeah, and we must not forget the Arts Council, right?
There's
a lot of people that.
Thank you,
everybody. And if I forgot someone, I'm sorry, and you can punch at me if you want. Honestly, we feel honored to be here, really. Thank you so much. So, yeah, printmaking is about sharing ideas, sharing.
A message?
Yes, well, an ideas, messages, feelings, and about share yourself to the people. I mean, printmaking is like doing a painting or a drawing, replicated whatever time you need. So this is a massive art, kind of art that involves the whole community, and as you can see, it is happening now, because you guys are here, because you guys are embedded with all these practices we have just bring with us to this community, this awesome community. So this is printmaking. Okay, now the topic of this day is about using different kinds of materials that are some of them, well, not everyone, not all of them are environmental friendly, but they are different materials that if you don't want to buy something, some linoleum in the Hobby Lobby, and I'm sorry for the
the store.
I'm sorry for the the publicity. But if you don't want to go there and buy that, the linoleum, you can make yourself your own plate using cardboard, this is already proof, this is aluminum paper, this aluminum, it's just cardboard and aluminum, and with that, and using a pen, you just start to draw, put some ink, and make the print. Well, this study has too much ink, but still you can see. You can see so a little bit of
detail.
Yes. Okay, what I'm now is giving you some samples about these different approaches of printmaking. And a little bit of background with the city we came from, León, Guanajuato, is that they specialize in making leather goods like wallets, shoes, and all other stuff. We as printmakers, we try to use these materials to approach a certain exhibition of our art. For instance, while Huerta is now handing you more pieces. Yes, those were made using scraps, things that you find in the trash. And you can make nice interventions, collages with your collecting use of the layout. And you can do your own layout, you can do your own design just using scraps. The thing with those wallets is that printmaking is not just about doing artwork that goes to a wall. Printmaking is also to make artwork that goes with you, or with you, like this. That's a bag. It used to be a t-shirt, and the t-shirt is now a bag with a nice printing on it. Any money? Nice. So yeah, as you can see, it really takes a lot. It really takes a lot of weight to inside my bag, so that's
right. You can wash it, so
yes.
It's reusable.
Yes, exactly. And with the wallets, they are a little bit more difficult to do, but anyway, you can have nice art in your pocket. What else? I'll be for the shoes.
No, I'll show you shoes. Yes, the main thing that we use in León is the leather, because it's very cheap. It's not as yes, because it's a dead cow, right? But it is very cheap in León, and we're trying to explore with different kinds of materials. Like that shoe is for the hard working class people, like farmers.
Construction workers too. And you can see the sole is made from a tire. So this is rustic, I know, maybe it's not a main issue, but still, maybe it's not Chanel, but still, you will not feel the, the thorns in your feet. So, that's what the main use, and you can also print in this, so you have art in your pocket, and also you are walking with art. What about that?
And because we don't have a big press in our house, we use this kind of machine that is a tortilla press. We make usually tortillas with this. Yes.
That's true, believe it or not.
Yes, I use I have one in my house to make tortillas and to make food. And we have one of these, like twice as big as this, and we use it to make bread.
Yeah, so this machine is just a different approach of the same function of a press. You know, you just need pressure to transfer the image to your desired surface. So the people regularly use this machine back in Mexico to make the tortillas, but we need some kind of way to do these things. So
and it's easy to carry on.
Yeah, well, it's kind of heavy, but anyway, you can take it and just go to the corner and start doing your prints and give it to the people. So, well, we have this.
This is a plate of linoleum. It has the shape of a tortilla, but I can make a we use the tortilla maker, putting the plate on it with some ink, and then I put the paper on the top with some felt. And the most important part is to do the impression in order to transfer all. Dr. Vargas in the opening made a print of the tortilla press. Here comes a printer.
So I have seen the prices of the press machines. They are expensive for you guys. It's more expensive for us.
In Mexico.
Yeah, so it's huge. It's crazy. So, well, you need the diverse ways of achieving your goal. And I'm pretty sure that painting, photograph, sculpture, also there must be some other ways to achieve the work you are trying to do. That. So, well, this is a nice machine. This is also a gift from us to Hannah Sanders, so she can use with you guys in the class. You can use this little machine to make your prints faster and without using too much, spending too much paper or work. So, well, this is for you guys.
It's for linoleum prints or wood also. It can maybe help for dry point.
No, for dry point. You will need more pressure, and that's a lot of strength you need to make on the tortilla press. So anyway, you can try.
As you can see, there's a picture of Luis with a big tire. Most of the pieces that are in Capo, we use that kind of wheel. It's from a tractor, and because we don't have a big press, and the other machine is not as big as a whole
Yeah, well, we
use the NBA for just to make me the impression. And also most, I think I'm using felt also to make the pressure even. So the thing with that, the tractor tire is that, as you can see, it has kind of dents over the surface, so you need to move the tire a lot of times. So you will be sure that the design will be pressed or even, and all the blacks will be the same in all the surface. Of course, it's very difficult to do with a tire. So I will say that I will hire the cross.
We need some cross people for
guys to move the tires. Oh yeah, just kidding. Yeah, so we need you guys to move all these tires. So we use that tire, sometimes we use a small tire, sometimes we just dance over them. Because the only thing we need is pressure. So I'm like, I don't know in pounds how much is it, like 200 pounds maybe?
I don't know.
Well, I'm too heavy, so. For small points, it's worth for the using your body, your hands, for small points. You can use a spoon, there's a lot of ways to do this. So, but with this one, it's even more easier. So, what else, guys?
You can mix it. You know, even with the paper and some other things, like this tobacco.
How can I say
this?
Oh yeah, well, you can achieve a lot of textures, mostly using the trash elements, well, the trash thing, the thing that we find in the trash, it's mostly used to make backgrounds, because you achieve interesting textures, and also, you don't need to, you just need a background that goes well with the feature that is of the foreground. So yeah, well, what you will see back in Catapult is we are using linoleum, we are using cardboard, we are using aluminum, we are using shoe soles. We go from the traditional to experimental, so you will find all that stuff out there. But the main idea of that solution is to show what we see, what we feel, and what we do in León, Guanajuato. We bring those feelings here to Cape Girardeau. In León, there's a community called Otomías. Otomías is a community of indigenous people, and they have tortillas, ceremonial tortillas. Something like this, of course, is those are edible, and they use natural pigments
from flowers.
So they can even without any issue. So they make these spring tortillas to celebrate something like, you know, the 15 years of the daughter.
A wedding. The saint of the church.
Because
well,
in
Mexico is known by this Catholic.
Yeah, we have a long tradition, so. We will find all kinds of celebrations out there. And the green tortillas is something different.
Something,
It's something different, it's something non-traditional that you will see in a piece of paper. You will see that in Mexico we try to bring everything we have to everything we can, just to, you know, express certain idea, or just because we want to do something. Yes, sorry.
No, I just wanted to ask, or maybe have you comment on the collaboration with you and Benji that relates to the tortillas.
Yeah, we were talking with Benji Hugh about these ceremonial tortillas, and we showed to him this machine. So he was like, you know, the normal reaction, like, really, that thing? Yes, that thing makes tortillas. What about if we do something with clay? So he came up and said, okay, let's do something. So we came on the clay, we made slabs with clay, and we printed some of these pieces on the clay. 47 pieces? Yes, we made a lot. And
less than an hour. Less than an hour.
I don't understand, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. So, we were talking with him about, okay, this is that. So he came with a great idea of, you know, to add color, to add the grays, to fire them up. So we made that group, and it came pretty well. I mean, something very, very different. So he started to do it, and we mixed our knowledge about painting, about printmaking, and his knowledge about ceramics, and something really, really nice come up. So you will see that installation tomorrow. You're more than welcome to go. I hope to see you guys there. And so it's a collaboration, which is the soul of this Palmer Gentes exhibition, that we are actually working together, working to do something singular, but something unique. I mean, sorry. So yeah, that's my idea of Palmer Gentes. Yes.
The installation you did with Benji, where is it going to be displayed?
Oh, at Carrefour.
Yes, we took a big print that we made together, and we're gonna put the installation there tomorrow. So it's a collaboration. He had a bust, a figure, a human figure, and we intervened the figure. And then we did the tortillas, and for us it was our first time working with clay, with ceramics. And Benji is an awesome teacher; he has a lot of patience with us. And it turned out very an incredible pieces.
Yes.
So if you go tomorrow, you will see the whole thing in the wall.
Yes, well, so I think this is part, the ceramics are part of the diverse materials we are trying to use to make, to stand a point about the idea of exchange, knowledge, and techniques. Because when we were working with him, we were exchanging techniques also. He was teaching us, and he didn't know about the printmaking. He didn't know about this machine, so he learned something, we learned something, and that's the beauty of the art, right? That we make a connection, we share things that are miles away from here, so that's great. And question?
There are a lot of students in the audience here. What would your advice be? Because you spent a lot of time with the students here at CAPE and with CMO students. What would your advice be to the students that you've come in contact with and have been working with in terms of their art making?
Yeah, well, I would say that don't stop what you are doing. Try to learn the more you can. Well, we came to Mexico and we see your installations that are great. For us, your installations have the university has great installations that you have all the things you need. I mean, at the reach of your hand, you will find something specially for that task. And I will say that approach that, embrace that opportunity, because it really will help you to develop your inner artist, your inner expression. I mean, an artist is someone who is related to humanity, to the human activities. So we're humans. I mean, we need to share everything we have, and we need to express ourselves, making art. So keep going.
And we have seen work from Candace. We bought her two pieces, the only one. And we saw Scott in ceramics. I mean, you guys are very talented. And we learned so much from you. I mean, every day you learn something, even we're old. You learn something every day. So, and don't quit what you are doing. If someone tells you that, oh, art is a stupid career that no one is going to buy anything, what are you going to leave? What are you going to do? There's no jobs for art people. It's totally incorrect. Keep doing what you're doing. There's someone, you probably won't.
Well, she means that there's public for everyone. I mean, the art is subject, it's subjective. The art for some people, it could be what you do. For some people, some people might find it not good, not right, with no technique. But that's subjective. I mean, everyone is a universe inside their heads. So the art can be pretty for some, ugly for others. No matter, you will find always someone that likes what you do. So keep going. Yes.
Of course, I'm very familiar with your past and where you guys come from, and as well as Joni, but could you guys sort of elaborate a little bit on your history and how you sort of started the collective in Mexico, so that these guys can have a background of where you're from and what sort of brought about Convergentes? Can you talk a little bit about that, about you three and how you've brought the collective together in Mexico?
Okay. Well, yeah, that's part of what I was talking about, that everyone is different. Everyone is different, but also it's the same too. The three of us converge in one point, in one kind of taste for art or something like that. I mean, Huerta has great ideas that share with us, and we share with him some of our ideas too. So we converge. And even that printmaking is about making copies and copies and copies of one of your artworks. Anyway, if you are doing even 100 copies, you will find that each one has maybe just a spot, maybe just something that makes different from the total series. That's how that's related to us. We are we produce the same, but at the same moment we are different. I have the idea, but I just let it go. Anyway, I'm sorry. Yeah. So, well, I forgot.
someone.
Thank you, Amelia. Also, one of
The main thing about working together is to the possibility of they influence my work. I can make a plate and work on it, but when I say what Alejandro is doing, and when I said the colors that Javier is printing, they affect me, and they produce in my work different expressions, because we are working like a group. So that's a very important thing about working in a class and in a workspace or something, because of this interaction.
Okay. Oh, I'm sorry, but you know, León, Mexico is a city of 2 million, right? There's 2 million people living there. So my real question is, what brought you guys together? Because I know Huerta is a mathematician, and you're a graphic artist. You both are graphic artists. How did you guys meet? How did you guys get this collective together? Because, you know, we really met Huerta through the group, so we're wondering what the history is of your sort of collective and your interest in printing. Because, you know, as a graphic artist, you had not done this before, is that right?
Yeah.
We met in a workshop in León with a teacher who is from Zacatecas. And that's how we met him, because we live together. So for us, it was like reuniting us with printmaking, because for 10 years I just quit doing things, art things, and I dedicate myself in other things. So it was like going back to school again in that workshop. So that's how the three of us know each other, because we're very different. Any other question? About Mexico? Sombreros, mariachi, tortillas, tacos, something?
Question.
Yes.
So how does the location of Mexico impact your subject matter? Or does it?
Well, the country is big, it's large, and you will find different culture at the north, the center, and at the south. So we are more related to the center of the country. So we have been also affected by weather. The weather in our city is very, it's temperate, it's warm. Yeah, so some things are not related to us, like